It's good to be in the Lord's house today. Say amen. Get you to stand with me. We're going to begin worship this morning with a song that says, my God is big enough. Doesn't matter what I face, doesn't matter what I go through, He's big enough. Amen. Sing this to me.
Amen. Sing this to him this morning.
help comes from Jesus. Amen. From the Lord. Sing this to him.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind. 'Cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
Church, and God's doing amazing. in our lives. Amen. He's doing that new work. And I'm excited about that aspect of what God's doing in our lives. I love to preach on the bigness and the greatness of God. I love that. I love to tell you how good my God is. Come on. I love to speak of His goodness. I love to speak of His mercies. I love to speak of His grace. I love to just tell you how blessed I am. Let me tell you something. Wednesday night, God showed His amazing, blessing power presence right here. When do you want to leave? That's how good He was to us. I'd love to tell you that. I'd love to tell you about my Jesus and what He's done for me. Say amen. And tell you of His goodness and tell you of His mercies and tell you of His graces. David said, can I ask, or the psalmist, this is Psalm 121, is a psalm of ascent. When the people of God would ascend to Jerusalem in the festival time or feast time, they would sing this song. And as they look up, they see the greatness. Because everywhere you would be coming to Jerusalem, you'd be coming looking up. And the writer says, Where does my help come from? Who's going to help me? Who's going to be there for me? And he said, my help comes from the Lord. The Lord who made this amazingness. The Lord who, listen, I remember Vernon telling me when y'all went to the mountains and to the Rockies. He said, and I said, well, I've been to Smoky Mountain. He said, you haven't seen nothing yet. He said, when you get to the Rockies, he said, it's just unbelievable. He said, you think you've seen the mountain in the Smoky Mountains? And I'm like, yeah, but he's like, you got to see the Rockies. I still remember that. Because when you see it, you know there's a God. When you see it, you know He's capable of doing anything. When you see it, you know He's amazing and powerful and just does incredible. You know it when you look up and you see the creation. And to think that's who helps you. That's who is there for you and me and us. Blows me away. That He would be willing to come alongside of us and to help us and to be there for us and to be our hope and our strength and our everything. Amen. When you see Him and you see His goodness, pray with me this morning. Holy God, we bow before You and thank You for the privilege and the honor of Sunday morning worship. And Lord, I'm here for no other reason but You. And Lord, I'm so excited. And it's almost like, God, I can just feel Your glory in this room. And feel Your goodness in this room. And feel the miracles that are in this place, Lord, because that's You. That's who You are. My God, my help, my Jesus, bless this time, we love You, we praise You, Jesus, listen to this, here, moving in our midst, come on, worship You. You are here working in this place. Worship You. Worship You.
promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Touching every heart,
I worship you, I worship you.
The Lord is the one that takes care of me. The Lord's the one that that ordains my steps, and he equips me, and he protects me, and he's there with me every step of the way. The Lord. That is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are.
That is who you are.
That is who you are. Somebody say, wow. Give him praise this morning. Amen. You may be seated. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. So for a few moments, I want to hang out in Psalm 121. Just breaking down a little bit. I mean, we can stop right there. Because God has spoken to, I hope he's spoken to you like he's spoken to me. But, when you think about this song that they would sing as they were on their journey to Jerusalem, a song of ascent. It's a song in which they would sing worshiping the Lord. And when you think about this song, and you think about what you know, as they're headed to worship, as they're headed to celebrate, and they're like, man, can I tell you how good my God is? Can I tell you how amazing my God is? And just all that he's done for me, and all that he's, you know, willing to do. Isn't it amazing? Say amen. That he would say, come to me, all of you that are struggling and life is hard, and bring all of your burdens to me and let me fix that. Let me do amazing in that and in your life with everything you're going through. And so they're like, where does my help come from? Where does our help come from? Where do you turn to when life slams you? Where do you turn to when life is difficult? Who do you run to when life is flipped upside down? And all it takes is a phone call for that to happen. Amen? Just a phone call, just a text message, just an email. Yeah, it doesn't take much these days. And life can be going from smooth sailing to way off the road. And so where do you turn to? A lot of times people turn to pills, or they turn to a bottle, or they turn to... Here's what they said. When my life is crazy, when my life is hard, when my life is messed up and turned upside, my help is in the Lord. My help is in the one who's the creator of the heavens and the earth. My help is in the one, and the only one that can fix this, the only one that can see me through. My help is in the Lord. And you know, I love the way that, because if you picture in their journey, you know, as they're headed up, they're looking up. Because a lot of times when life slams you, and a lot of times when life, maybe you're discouraged or you're down, or what do? We tend to look what? Down, don't we? You know, you just kind of, man, life is so... Here's what they said. Look up. Look up. And I'm guilty of looking down. I'm guilty of not looking up like I should. But I love this. They said, we look up. My help comes from the Lord. They said, I look to the mountains. I look and see of his amazingness. I look and see of all that he's done for me. I look to him. And you know, you think about it. Isn't it amazing that he's like, I'm ready for this. I want to do this. I want to be in the God of creation, the God of heaven. You know, you think about this for a second. He wants to be involved in my life. He wants to be a part of my life. I don't know about you, but that amazes me. Come on. And here's what they said about this God that amazes me, this God that says, I want to be a part of your life, Kim. I want to walk with you. I want to be there for you. It says this. It says, He, not Kim, He will not allow your foot to be moved. He, the one who keeps you, your God, your Lord, your Jehovah, your Jesus, He keeps you. And it says this, guys, not only will He not allow your foot to be moved, but He keeps you. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel doesn't slumber, will either slumber or sleep. And you say, what's important about that? It's because here's what that's saying. God's on duty, and I don't want to minimize by and just throwing phrases out there of who we're speaking of here. But He's on duty 24/7. Amen? Because everybody look this way, your life happens 24/7. You know, you don't need somebody that in the middle of the night when you get the phone call, you need to be able to understand and believe and experience and realize that, hey, when you cry out to God, He's not asleep. Even though they woke you up to give you the message, He's not asleep. He's not slumbering. When you say, where is He, preacher? He's still on the throne of heaven, where He always is. He's still in charge and in command, like He always is. He's still sovereign. He's still, everything's still bowing down to Him. You know, and so He neither sleeps nor slumbers. It's strange to me, guys, because life can be crazy at any moment. And so at any moment, God's like, I'm available. It doesn't matter. I'm here. No matter what's going on in your life, no matter what time it is, no matter, you know, I'm available. I'm available. You know why you can trust Him? Because He is always available to you. He is always available. You know, in 2 Chronicles 16, chapter 16 and verse 9, it says this, the eyes of the Lord run true to and fro throughout the whole earth to show Himself strong on behalf of those whose heart is loyal to Him. In other words, here's the picture. Now, God's up on the throne of heaven, and He's not slumbering. He's not sleeping. And He looks down, and there's Ken in the middle of a struggle, in the middle. And not only that, but He knew what was going to happen. He knew what was going to go on. He ordained my steps. Come on. And He's there at that very second to meet my name.
Amen.
That very second, He's there. I'm available. I'm available anytime. I'm available. He does not sleep. He does not slumber. And you're not overwhelming Him when you pray to Him. You haven't, I love to say this and I believe this in my heart, you haven't caught God off guard. Come on. You haven't surprised Him. Oh, God, help me, help me. You haven't surprised Him. He's right there. He knows what's going on. He knows what's happening. And He makes Himself available. You ever had somebody you tried to get a meeting with and they wouldn't make themselves available to you? I have. You ever had somebody, you know, and think about this. This is the Creator of the heavens and the earth. As you're walking and ascending this hill to Jerusalem, and you're looking at the mountains, and you're just like amazed. Boy, isn't this awesome? Awesome. I remember the last time we went to the mountains, and we took this trail, and it's the same trail that guy coming down. The first time I took it, he looked at me and said, this ain't fat boy friendly. And I'm like, he's coming down. He's sweating profusely. And I mean, he's breathing hard. He's coming down. And we're walking up and we're just enjoying the scenery. But we get up there to that area. And my mountain climber, she just takes, I'm like, get back. scared me to death.
Why are you hanging off that tree over that mountain? No, she wasn't hanging off the tree. Close, it looked like, you know. And I turned around, I'm looking for her one time. Jack, I couldn't find her. She's over there. I had to end up taking pictures, and she wanted to get that bad shot. I'm like, you know, here's what God says. And it was amazing, the sight you could see. And here's what God says. As they're ascending up that, on that journey to Jerusalem, and they're looking up, and they're thinking, man, isn't this amazing? And this is who's with me. This is whose help I have. This is who's got my back. This is who's protecting me, providing for me. This guy, my Lord Jesus, is doing, you know, as I look around and see this, he's the one who's taking care of me. And you say, oh, preacher, he's God. He's got guys at his angels at his command and to do whatever. I want to keep reading just for a second. It says in let's go back, verse 2. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved. Did it say an angel? It said what? He. Just go with me here a second. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. Now look at verse number 5. My Bible says, the Lord is my keeper. The Lord is my keeper. It's him. I love the New Living Translation. It says it this way, guys. The Lord himself. I love that. The Lord himself. Look around and see the greatness and see the goodness and see the amazingness of all that he's done and all. I mean, look around and hear and see the amazingness. Come on. And see the goodness and see the miracles. And think about this. That's the one watching out over you. The Lord himself is the one who's watching out over you. And you say, preacher, let me tell you something. He's God. He's got this. He can handle this. I love the story of Daniel. When Daniel's praying, and as Daniel's praying in Daniel chapter 9, he said, I was speaking, I was praying, I was confessing my sin and the sin of my people Israel and presenting my supplication before the Lord, my God, for the holy mountain of my God. He said, yes, while I was speaking in prayer, the man Gabriel, angel, whom I had seen in the vision at the beginning, being caused to fly swiftly, reached me about the time of the evening offering. He informed me and he taught with me and he said this. He said, oh, Daniel, I have now come forward to give you skill to understand. At the beginning of your supplications, the command went out. Who sent the command out? Where'd that command come from? Who does Gabriel answer to? He answers to the Lord. He answers to Jehovah. He answers to God. Come on. Amen. He is the one sitting at the feet of God. He is the one when God gives direction. And I want you to see this. He said at the beginning of your son, when you began to pray, Daniel, I got the directions. When you began to pray, Daniel, somebody was involved. Somebody was sitting on the throne of heaven. Somebody's in control and in charge. Somebody's involved in your life, Daniel. And his name is Jehovah. His name is the Lord. And at that very moment, he himself gave me the directions to come. He could send anything. He could have somebody set up to take care of Ken. And you know what he says? I got this. He could have somebody set up to take care of both of you. And you know what he says? I got this. Amen. I've got this. He himself, the Bible says, is the one watching over me. He himself is the one taking care of me. He himself is the one protecting me and comforting me. Look what he said. He said, he's your shield. He is your shade and your right hand, the latter part of verse 5. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. He is your shade. He is your comforter. And then you get out, and it won't be long, we'll be experiencing massive heat. Come on. It ain't long. It'll be here for a while. Amen. And even in the heat, it's hot in the shade. But in the shade, you get some what? Relief. You get some comfort. And it can still be hot. You know, it can still be a mess in your life. But somebody needs to hear. He'll be that shade. When the heat's turned up, he'll be that shade and that comforter in the middle of what you're going through, in the middle of when the heat is cranked up. He said, I'll be there. And the heat's still going to be cranked up. He said, but I'm going to comfort you in the middle of what you're going through. Have you ever experienced that? Amen. In the middle of something of life's messes, the Lord, who's your helper, the Lord who created, who's your Savior, who's your sustainer, who's your provider. And life got flipped upside down. And he wasn't asleep when it happened. He wasn't slumbering. He wasn't caught off guard. And just like that, he brought some comfort and peace in your situation. Come on. Amen. And that's what he's promising you. I'll provide for you. I'll take care of you. I will be there for you. I will be there. No matter what you need. I love the fact that the verse 7, the latter part of verse 7, or the verse 7 says, the Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out, your coming in, from this time forward. What a promise that he's watching over me physically. He's watching over me spiritually. He's taking care of me. He's providing for me. And bless God, one day Ken's going home. And when I get home, I'm not home yet. I'm just traveling, you know, just on a journey, kind of like the Israelites, where as they're saying, I'm on that journey. Oh, why? But one day I'll get home. And when I get home, I'm going to get home because of him. I'm not going to get home because of Ken. I'm going to make it to heaven, Wanda, not because of anything Ken's done, but because of everything Jesus did. Amen? Because he's the one that died for me. He's the one that paid the wage of sin. He's done this for me, and he's the one taking care of me. He's the one providing for me. He's the one that's going to make sure that I make it home.
Amen.
That's my Jesus. That's my Lord. That's my help. He's there for me, taking care of me, providing for me day after day after day after day. He's protecting me. And I love this. It says he's going to watch over my comings and my goings both now and forever. Now and forever. Want some good news today? Even when you mess up. Because I'm gonna submit something to you. We're close. Mark. I'm gonna submit something to you this morning. There's not a perfect person in this room. Period. Not me, not you, not us. We're the Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Amen. You know, you think about it. We're all, and you know, if I was dependent upon me to get me to heaven, I'd have messed up a long time ago, and I sure wouldn't have made it. I'm not dependent on me. He's gonna preserve me. He's gonna preserve my going out and my. Who's gonna do this? Who's gonna do this? Jesus, the Lord. The Lord, he's going from this time forth, and even what? Help me out. Forevermore. That means when I fail and I do fail, it's not over. My failures aren't final. My failures mean that I have a God that loves me enough that's going to send His Holy Spirit to convict me of my wrongdoing. And show me in the Word and just say, hey, Ken, let's fix this. Let's deal with this. He's going to make sure I make it home. He's going to make sure I make it home. Not me. Not me. I'm not my help. My help is my Jesus. And Him alone. Amen. My Lord. Guys, let me tell you something. And I love this. Not only is He involved in my life and in your life individually, He's involved in our lives as a people. He hasn't given up on us. He's still God. He's still walking with us. He's still willing to help us. He's still willing to protect us and provide for us and to bless us. He's still sovereign. He's still on the throne of heaven. He's still in control. He's still God enough to do anything. Come on. Whether it's me, or you, or us, my help, my help, our help is the Lord. Amen? Amen. Pray with me. Father God, wow. What an encouragement from Your Word. I love Jesus to tell people about how good You are. I love Jesus to tell how faithful You are, even when I'm not faithful, You're faithful. How committed You are. Lord, my prayer for this time right here is that we would take just a moment and say, thank You, Jesus. Just a moment. Just a moment. To say, Lord, You're so, so, so good to me. You're so amazing. Jesus, You're my help in my time of need. You're my hope in my time of despair. You're my peace and comfort in time of turmoil and craziness in my life. Jesus. Jesus. Lord, my prayer is that if there's one in here that said, you know, I don't know the Jesus you know, preacher. I've heard about Him. I believe He is. But I believe Him with my head and not my heart. Lord, I pray today would be a time of salvation. Today would be a day of believing with our heart, Lord, that Jesus, You are the Son of God, and that You died for my sins, and that You're on the throne of heaven, and that every single thing answers to You. And so no matter what I'm facing, my eyes are lifted up. No matter what I'm going through, my eyes are lifted up to my Lord.
Amen.
Who takes care of me. Lord, that would be their testimony too. Jesus, I love You. I love You. Bless this time in Jesus' name. All God's people said amen.